So this is one of the most requested videos on my channel ever since this. By the way, I've also taken a while without uploading any, and I'm sorry. Thank you so much for always supporting me regardless. So the COVID updates that I'm going to give in this video are from the presidential address that took place on 28th of October this year, 2021. Hi travel loves, it's Jacenta here. Thanks for choosing to travel with me. Just so you know, I'm hosting a group trip next year in April of 2022. It's going to be a safari, 7 days, Martian Falls. So the link is below in my description. There you'll find the itinerary, everything that's included on the full price, and the full price itself. So if you're new here, thank you for coming in, and if you're already a subscriber, thank you. If you're new here and you would like to join us on this group trip, and you feel like, who the hell is this girl? I would like to join her, but I don't know her. Feel free to join me, to follow me up on Instagram. I'm always there, very active, so you can get to learn about me and, you know, see if this is something you can join next year with us. I have only 6 spots open on this, so can't wait to welcome you next year in the Pearl of Africa. So I have some notes about the COVID updates here, so I'll be looking in my notebook. So, you know, so first things first, I'm going to display a certain notes here on the screen. It says, just in case the words are very small, it says, all arriving passengers at Entebbe International Airport will be subjected to COVID-19 tests, regardless of the country of origin or vaccination status. The only exemption is kids of 6 and below. Yeah, but for the rest, it's mandatory. This is not how it was in the past. Usually, you would come with your COVID test, you know, you would come with your test, COVID test results from whichever country you're flying in from. And, you know, they consider that to either let you in or, you know, but now it's mandatory. You're going to make it from the airport, the entire airport. Don't come with your own test results from anywhere else. Yes. Then another one is, passengers traveling out of the country will be required to have negative COVID-19 test certificate taken within 72 hours from the time of sample collection. They will abide by the health travel requirements of the destination country that they're heading to. I don't know if that's right English for me, but you abide by the COVID regulations of the next country you're flying to. I don't know if I'm confusing you guys, but you can replay this over and over until you understand what I'm talking about. The cost of the mandatory COVID-19 test is $30. So as you're planning to come to Uganda, make sure you have $30 kept aside for this mandatory testing for all incoming passengers, including you watching this video. This COVID-19 video, someone commented asking me like some of the websites where they can get this information, updated information about COVID. Well, I have a tip. I'm still researching about those websites, but I already have a tip. This tip can work for you regardless of the country you're going in. I would advise you to always follow the national carrier of that country, the airline, you know. If you, for example, here in Uganda, follow Uganda Airlines. When you follow Uganda Airlines, whichever updates come in, they're always among the first people to post them, because these airlines belong to the government. So I think that's my big tip, but I'll keep researching. If I get these websites, I'll let you know, and, you know, I'll make a video or somewhere on my Instagram and post them there. But for now, that's my tip. If you're traveling to Tanzania, follow Air Tanzania on their Twitter or somewhere. Whenever there are any changes happening at the airport, mandatory things, mandatory documents you require to have, those national airlines always post those things first, because they're owned by the government and it's the government that comes up with these changes. So be informed that it's now 19 months since we registered the very first COVID victim here in Uganda, and we've had 2 waves so far. We've lost people like 3,000 something, and by the moment of silence for these people who we lost, not only here in Uganda but worldwide, because every life matters, regardless. Black lives matter, but okay, let's deeper. Every life matters, so let's get a moment of silence for these people. Thank you so much, and may their souls keep resting in eternal peace. The president also said that the general economy of Uganda will fully open up in January of 2022. So don't forget, I'm hosting a group trip in April 2021, where the entire economy will be open. So if you've been considering traveling to Uganda, and a group trip or a group safari, something that sounds great to you, feel free to read all the details in the link below in my description. You'll find there the itinerary, the full price, what is included, what's not, what is excluded. It will be a 7-day group trip, and yeah, I can't wait to see you there. If you don't know me yet and you'd like to join me, it's very fine. Follow me up on Instagram. I'm always active there. You get to know about me. You get to see if I'm someone you can trust. And yeah, I can't wait to see you here in Uganda. See you in my next video. Stay safe. Bye.